Hello and welcome. I'm Rogue Royce, back at it again with another reaction video. Up next, we've got ourselves another daily throwback. The song is called Pata Pata by South African singer Miriam Makeba, and this is a live performance, 1967. So let's see how they were jamming back then to this tune. And if you hear the cat crying in the back, that's Tyson. Ignore him.
Here is the magnificent African artist, Miriam Makeba.
Magnificent. Straight away with the vibes. Okay, this is a vibe. I feel like I may have heard this because it's very catchy. I know I've heard this before. This vibe. Just the beginning part I know, but this, I wasn't expecting her to go low like that. Okay, break it down, Miriam. Grooving in the 60s, that is for sure. There's not much going on. It's just her magnificent voice. He said it. The drums, the two chicks in the back just vibing along. And they set the mood. I'm vibing over here. I'm feeling good over here. This is a jam. Pata pata, come on. Pata, pata, mama. Because, ooh, she can go low, she can go high. What can Miriam not do? Because she can groove too, that's for damn sure. Just a little spin here, pata pata. You better start moving. Her voice is so good. I forgot there were instruments happening in the song, and I just tuned back into the instruments, and homeboy is vibing on the drums. This woman, Miriam Makeba from Joburg, I'm sure she turned those clubs up. They were just shimmying back and forth, vibing. Because that sounds so familiar, I just can't remember where I've heard it and when I've heard it, but man, was that wavy. Like, again, there wasn't much going on in that performance, and there was no need. It was such a vibe, just her voice hitting those highs. Like, homeboy said it in the beginning, magnificent voice. She had all the range. The two chicks in the back just grooving, doing their thing, here for it, and then the drummer as well, tapping away. But I got lost and focused in on just her. That's how captivating she is. I'm in awe of this woman. So graceful, so timeless, so classy. I saw that she was called the Queen of Africa, and after what I just saw, I believe it. Her voice, powerful, just like the rest of the voices I've heard coming out of Africa. Let me know what you thought about that song in the comments down below. Let me know if you know why it's so familiar in my head. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, peace, love, and party on.